Hey children, welcome back again. Hope you all are doing good and enjoying the videos as usual. Okay, so in the last video already we have discussed lot many things of this topic, bones and the muscles. So today we are at end of this topic, that is we have learnt about the skeleton system, we have learnt about the parts of the skeleton, we have learnt about the joints. And we have learned about the types of joints, how many types of joints are there and exactly where they are present and what is their work. These all things we have learned. In this video, we are learning about bones. About bones we have already learned. In this video, we are learning about the muscles. So then, what is this muscles exactly? For muscles, we don't have the exact definition that so I can define like that, like this. But I can explain. So there is a very nice explanation about the muscles. See here children, when we are telling about bones and joints, there are a lot many bones in our body. They have joined together to form this definite structure. Not only the human body, even other animals' body also, there are lot many bones are there. So when bones are joined together, we know that different bones are there. They have joined together in the different named by the different names of the joints, and they have joined and they are performing the particular work or particular function. So when the bones are joining in the joints, okay, then it is not at all possible without the muscles. Then these muscles will help to join the bones. See here, we have here one bone and here one bone, okay. So these two bones are, of course, here it is joined with the help of the joint, but there are the muscles. See here, here also we have muscles, here also we have muscles. This soft and elastic structure which is attached with the skin of our body, this we have muscles. Okay, here also we have muscles. The soft part, this is also muscle, and here also we have muscle in the thigh part, in the hip we have the muscles, and here we have the muscles. So muscles are there almost throughout our body. You know what, there are more than 600 muscles are there in our body, and most number of muscles are present in the this head part or face part and the neck part. So here we have more than the whatever we have other part of the body. So more than 600 muscles are working to join our bones in our body. So these muscles, even not only joining of the bones, these muscles will help to move the bones, movement of the bones. Along with this joint, these muscles are going to help in moving, that may be away from the body or towards the body. See here, for example, here I have told you, here we have the muscles, here this is also muscle, okay, here also muscle, here also muscle, and here also muscle. For example, these muscles will help. How these are going to help? See here, these are the soft and elastic in nature. This muscle, now it is expanded like this in the relaxed position now. So when this bone is coming near to this bone, this muscle is going to become closer to each other. Muscles are going to become closer to each other. And always muscles will work in pairs. Okay, in the pair. So one is helping to move towards this side. This muscle is helping to move towards this side. And this muscle is moving this side. When I want to do straight this hand, so these two muscles are helping, again working in pair. This is becoming relaxing up in relaxing position, and even this is also becoming in a relaxing. Same thing happens in the legs also. So this is how the muscles will help the movement of the bones and the joints. And muscles will help to give the definite structure for the bones and joints. See, just you assume there is nothing other than the skeleton in our body. How do it look? There is no shape for our body. There is no clear picture. How do I look? How do you look? So only that is only the because of the muscle. See, just you assume here is a skull. Here inside the brain is there. There is no muscle. How do my face look? just like a dead body, not only dead body, just like a skeleton. How do you see in your science lab and how do you see in the films? No, just like that we all will look, because all of us we have the same type of skeleton. So that is the muscle which giving us the beauty, or that which is giving us the definite shape, which is giving us a clear picture that how do I look, how do my body looks. See, this my, I have like this face, somewhat this is round in shape, that is only because of the muscle. And some of you have the egg shaped face, that is only because of the muscle. See, I have my shape of my hand is like this, bit Humpty Dumpty and bit fat, that is because of muscles, what amount of muscles I have. This is how the muscles will help in when they become contract, the bones are understood that they are moving towards each other, they are moving closer to each other. When the muscles are becoming in a relaxed position, it means what, the this joint or this bone is moving away from the body. Okay, this is how the muscles are going to help in the movement of the bones. And then we have in the muscles that softness or that elasticity, that is because of some types of tissues. Those tissues are called as the tendons, and these tendons, these tissues always work in pair. As I told you, muscles always work in the pair. Even those tissues are attached in the muscles. In the muscles there are tissues, those tissues are called as tendons, and those tendons always work in the pair to contract the muscles and to become relaxed position for the muscles. And this was about muscles, what are the muscles and how exactly what they are going to do. This was the about the muscles. Then even we have in the muscles also we have types. There are three types in the muscles. Then what are those three types? Voluntary muscle, involuntary muscle, cardiac muscle. So as the name itself indicates, voluntary muscle means what? These are the muscles where when we give some signals, if I want to move my hand, if I want to write, I want to take pen, yes, my brain is giving the, for this hand the signal that go and take that pen, I will go and take this chalkpiece, as my brain told me I have taken. Because how do I have taken? Here muscles, bones, everything is there attached to each other, and these muscles are working in my control. Okay, in my control. Then this type of muscles, the muscles which we have in the neck. Okay, so if I want to rotate my head or my neck towards the board, yes, I can rotate, and I can again rotate towards the phone. Then if I want to rotate my hand, if I want to move my hand, my legs, okay, my this trunk, if I want to move, so I can move like this. So the muscles which are there under our control or brain control, those all muscles are called as, for example, hand, leg, neck, these all are called as the voluntary muscle. Then opposite of this, there are some type of muscles. For example, we have muscles in the heart, we have muscles in the kidney, and we have some other internal organs like liver, like intestine, like stomach, like pancreas. Every part of our organs of our body have some amount of muscles. There are some internal parts, many internal parts are there, those are also having the muscles, but those muscles will not listen to my brain. See, if suppose today I am getting bored of this life, I told my heart, see please, the muscles whichever are there in my heart, please stop this, yeah, I don't want to live. My heart is not at all going to listen my the signal, whatever I am speaking to that. If I decide, see yaar, I am feeling bored, I don't want to write, okay, I told to my hand, then this is throwing this chalkpiece. Is of course these muscles are voluntary, they have listened my, they are under my control, they have listened my whatever I have told, they have listened my words. But I am telling my heart, please stop it yaar, I don't want, please stop it, don't beat again and again. If I say like this, my heart won't listen my words, because the heart, kidney, and the some other intestine, pancreas, liver, stomach, whatever the internal organs are there, those muscles will not listen, because they are not there under our control. When we have born, that from that time only they are functioning there functions or they are doing their role, then these type of muscles are called as involuntary muscles. See children, in this video we have discussed about muscles, how many number of muscles are there, then exactly how do the muscles help for movement of the bone, and where the more number of muscles are there in the face and the neck, and the tissues, what name is called for the tissues which are there in the muscles, that is tendons, and types of muscles, voluntary, involuntary, and the cardiac. So about the cardiac and next part we will discuss in the next video. So in this video I am going to end up this video. Before ending this video I would like to give you some questions, like you can write what are muscles, what are the number of muscles are present in our body, and what are the types of, what are the tendons, next question, and what are the types of muscles. We can write these questions, answer for these questions. I hope you will write these answers, and let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself and bye bye.